Among the 47 counties in Kenya, there is one in the former Rift Valley province. It is known as the County of Champions, a county with three topographic zones, namely the Highlands, Kerio Valley, and the Escarpment. This is Elgeyo Marakwet County, the County of Champions. The expansive county has 20 administrative wards. The governor, Alex Tanui Tolgos, is a mechanical engineer by profession. He is a precise, visionary, and goal-oriented leader with the welfare of the residents at heart. He seeks to incorporate his accountancy skills to robustly grow the economy of the county through accountable leadership. Elgeyo Marakwet County covers a total area of 3,029.9 kilometers squared. It borders West Pokot County to the north, Baringo County to the east, Trans Nzoia County to the northwest, and Uasin Gishu County to the west.
Since the inception of devolution, a lot has happened, not only in Elgeyo Marakwet, but in the country in general.
Upon establishment of the devolved system of governance in Kenya after the general election in March 2013, the county government undertook to formulate a system that would address the most important needs of the people.
It is in this particular document that the aspirations of our people are embodied. The CIDP acknowledged the resource potential of our county. It acknowledged the capabilities of our population. It also acknowledges the strengths and the weaknesses that this county has. But more than that is that the plan did set out a clear roadmap that moves Elgeyo Marakwet from where it is at that time in 2013 to 2017 through a set of anticipated interventions that will ultimately give the results that the county aspires to.
Elgeyo Marakwet County Government has therefore initiated people-oriented projects all over the county.
When we came to office, we did a follow-up, and myself and a team from the county visited Belgium in Brussels, where we went to discuss about the project. And we are happy that soon people in Elgeyo Marakwet County are going to get water. We know that for a very long time our town, Iten, which is a world known town for athletics training, has been having water challenges. But this is a game changer. It's going to solve all the water issues in Iten.
The project has evolved very well. And as an ambassador, I'm very proud to see that we are facilitating this type of important project. Like, water is life, and it's crucially important for everyone to have drinkable water.
Quality health is central to human happiness and well-being. It also makes an important contribution to economic progress, as healthy populations live longer, are more productive, and save more. The county government has refurbished former forsaken health facilities in the county.
Many of our dispensaries were dysfunctional. They were there, yes, but supplies were not there. But currently, almost virtually all our dispensaries are functional. We want to do what we call reverse referral, where medical consultants can be taken to the field, like Tot, like Kocholwa, those hard to reach areas, so that they can attend to people there. Whatever they identify, the consultants can as well go and attend to the identified cases in those locations.
New equipment have been bought at Iten Hospital, and medicine has been procured and distributed in the dispensaries across the county. The County Executive Committee Member for Health, Thomas Ruto, says they have acquired 5 ambulances that enhance referral and rescue services of critical medical cases. The county has also employed more than 380 nurses who have been distributed in the county. However, he adds that they look forward to a modern information system.
We do believe that we still can gain more by having a health management system that can actually, in real time, give us the drug and stock levels in all our centers, and even give us data on the kind of disease prevalence in our county, and even enable us to efficiently control leakages in drugs and control staff.
The county government has also rehabilitated the 160 kilometers squared Rimoi National Reserve by employing warders and rangers while restocking the reserve with the game. It is expected to open gates in the next 2 months.
I want to encourage investors in the hospitality industry to come to our county. We are ready after the cable car visibility study, of course, and again now the ecology. We are going to express an interest on the papers, and we encourage you to apply and come and invest in our county. We now have a plan with Kenya Power. They already done the Boresha Umeme, and they've added more families. Households are now getting power. On green energy, we have very high potential. We have hydro, we have our rivers at Aror River, Embabut River, Torok and Talal Rivers, which have very high potential of hydro.
The county has naturally rich soils and has taken the opportunity to concentrate on agribusiness, with the county government highly subsidizing quality seeds and seedlings for cash crops like tea, coffee and tissue culture bananas. It is also promoting irrigation of farms in the dry areas, as well as supporting value addition to agricultural produce.
County government amesaidia sisi kuletea sisi watu ya agriculture, ameletea sisi mbegu. Tunaona hiyo ni jugu anaweza fanya site, anaweza fanya mzuri kwa hapa kuliko ile yote.
In collaboration with partners in the agricultural sector, the county government has provided eco-friendly solutions like this fruit fly trap for mango farmers.
Dawa yenye iko ndani ni dawa nyingine inaitwa pheromone ama fruit fly pheromone, ambao inasaidia sana kufuta wale wanaume wa fruit fly. Na hiyo iko na harufu ya kuwaputia. Wakisikia hiyo harufu wanakimbia, wanaingia ndani. Ikiingia ndani, hiyo pheromone sumu inaanza kuwaua ndani. So kwa hivyo tunaposimama hapa hivi, wakulima wengi wamependa hii idea.
The subsidy initiative has been extended to the dairy industry by subsidizing artificial insemination services and buying milk coolers.
Kabla tuko tumepata kula, tuko tunauza maziwa yetu kwa brokers, na brokers walikuwa natukula sana kwa sababu walikuwa wanachukua in form of liters, na hapa tunatumia kilos. Na kilos inatusaidia jinsi unavyolisha ng'ombe yako, naleta maziwa ile mzito. Kulinganisha na bei ya wakati ule, ni kwamba wakati ule ilikuwa na broker mwenyewe anaamua bei yake kwa sababu hatukuwa na otherwise, lakini sasa hizi bei imeimprove. By then tunauza maziwa ama kula inatuchukulia maziwa na shilingi 36 kwa kilo moja, na imekuwa ya manufaa kwetu.
Elgeyo Marakwet County is endowed with 3 topographic zones, all of them separated by the conspicuous Elgeyo Escarpment, thus has a ranging terrain.
Since the coming of the county government, we've done 153 kilometers of new roads. We have sections in this county that do not have a road completely. We have improved and maintained 282 kilometers of road network across the county. The roads we've opened entails, as you call, cattle spoil, opening up a road completely, because most likely we'll have had a small track, a simple path. And we do survey, we open up the road, and we put furniture, we do culverts, and we put maram to make it all weather.
Education is a basic human right, which is why the county government has put effort in refurbishing the early childhood education centers to give the children a kickstart in their education path.
Kitambo tulikuwa tunaketi kwa ile miti huko before closing day. Tukaenda county wakatupatia vitabu, textbook 19 textbooks, chalks, crayons na manila papers. Tunawashukuru sana.
Tulifurahi kuchagua darasa upya na kuletea vitabu.
The main economic activity of the residents is farming and trading of various products.
We are encouraging the members of the public and other investors to come and invest, because there's various opportunities in almost all the sectors. Iten, for instance, can grow to Nairobi in the next few years. It's only that we need to really come back and try to share our skills, our ideas, and tap the necessary resources and channel it appropriately.
We do believe also that we have a lot of capacity to mobilize additional revenues, but that revenue cannot be achieved with the current manual system, where our staff are still receiving revenues and delivering cash. We truly need a revenue management system that can actually control leakages, increase operational efficiency, and reduce the wage bill. We appeal to partners, to those already in Elgeyo Marakwet, to those who have shown interest in coming to Elgeyo Marakwet, and to those who may see our potential and our dream and our strategy to join us in delivering a part of it, each one of them taking a piece of the projects that are here. We will be accountable to any support that you give us, not only to our partners, but we will be accountable to the people of Elgeyo Marakwet and Kenya as a whole.
The governor, Engineer Alex Stolgos, underscores the potential the county would realize is immense, based on the enhanced and accountable governance systems his government has put in place.
When we started this county government, we started by doing our county integrated development plan, CIDP. And this CIDP for 5 years, 2013-2017, we require about 38 billion to actualize all the projects in the CIDP. However, basing on what we receive from National Treasury, it means that we are receiving an average of one billion per year. So it means that by the end of 5 years, we'll only be having 5 billion. So leaving a deficit of about 33 billion. But I want to appeal to the private sector, the donors and all the partners who can join hands with Elgeyo Marakwet to come and invest in Elgeyo Marakwet, because we have a lot of potential in tourism, in health, in agriculture, and we even have companies now doing exploration in Elgeyo Marakwet for oil, and we believe that we have a lot of natural resources. We have minerals in Elgeyo Marakwet. Your security is guaranteed in Elgeyo Marakwet, and I believe that there are so many opportunities.
Welcome and savour the hospitality and the beauty of Elgeyo Marakwet County, the county of champions. Be part of the champions.